Paul McKenna, I'm here today with Tony Bellew for PT Boxing. How are you, Tony? You okay?
I'm okay, thanks, mate.
Just here for the press conference for All or Nothing, June 26th. Your fight's just being announced. Good fighter, not world level, but he's a decent fighter. He's a good fighter.
It is, mate. He's got 33 wins on his resume. He doesn't have them for nothing, you know what I mean? He's earned every one of them 33 wins. It's going to be a good fight. This is the longest I've ever been out of a ring since it's in professional. So, I'm looking to get, back in the mix straight away, and I just want to get fighting again, mate. I've missed fighting so much.
Yeah, I think everyone's missed you fighting as well, Tony. Obviously, once you've got this fight out the way, providing everything goes well, as we all expect it to, just being speaking about Juan Pablo Hernandez there.
Yeah.
A very, very tough fight, as you said, probably besides, well, it's between him and Hooker to be the best in the division, so it's a tough fight, but one that you'd enjoy, Tony, and one that you'd like to fight.
It is, yeah, mate, it is. It's a hard fight, but like I say, I've never been one who ducks or dodges anyone, so for me, Hernandez is the best in the division, and I want to fight the best. I want to beat him and then stand back on that roof I've just been on before and say I'm the best fighter in the world at cruiserweight. So, I believe that can happen, and I believe I'll beat Juan Pablo Hernandez, but like I say, I have to be the best I've ever been, show something that I've never shown before, and just get in there and give it everything I've got, excuse me.
So it's fine. You spoke about it before. I'd love to see it as well, being an Evertonian fighting at Goodison. Do you think that's a possibility, you and Hernandez at Goodison?
It is a possibility, and it really was. I mean, if I'd never done the movie, I think there was a possibility it could have happened. But I'd done the movie because things just... Cleverly fight came. There was a lot of negative criticism after the fight because of the things that he'd done by running all night. And it's kind of like it was levelled at me as well. When they look back at the fight now, they say, well, it actually wasn't that bad of a fight. And you can see I'm the one pressing all night, and I'm the guy who's wanting to have a fight, but the other guy didn't want to fight. So it's kind of levelled out a bit now, and I've come home, and let's say I've got this fight next, and I'm just looking forward to getting back in the ring now. That's all that matters to me. I love boxing, I love fighting, and June 26th can't come soon enough.
Yeah, can't come soon enough for all the fans as well. Just touching on a day, just being to Vegas, obviously, to watch Mayweather Pacquiao. What was that like as an experience, Tony?
Unbelievable. I've never seen nothing like it in my life. I wouldn't say I'm the biggest fan of Vegas. It's not me at all, but I was there to watch a fight and there to help BBC Radio go over the fight and talk about the fight and study it and how breaking it down. Yeah, I broke it down really well in the end, so maybe with the win it'd be easy.
Yeah, so, and it was, yeah.
I broke it down, it was easy. He's in a level on his own.
No, a lot of people have given criticism, just as you said, that with the Cleverley fight, a lot of people have criticised Mayweather after Pacquiao for a similar thing, saying it's boring and it was, just a one-sided fight, but...
People have got to understand, right, that every single boxer that's ever graced this sport or been a boxer, if they could win a fight and not get hit, believe you me, they would choose to do that.
Course,
no fighter enjoys getting hit in the face. No fighter enjoys being in wars. And I'll take it from someone who knows, I've been in wars. I've dragged myself off the floor. I've fought with broken hands. I've fought guys that won't stop coming and you can't keep them off. And they're hitting me at will. Now, Floyd Mayweather is that good that he can defuse all them things. He can take everything away from you and you can barely land a glove on him.
Yeah.
You see his face after that fight. He didn't even look like he'd been in a fight. He looked like he'd been for a jog.
Yeah.
It was an unbelievable win, an unbelievable victory. Never. What people forget is never before in boxing has pound for pound number one faced number two, because they've never been the same weight.
Yeah.
Many years ago, you talk about pound for pound greats. They're always weight divisions apart. It's like there's Joe Louis and then there's the strawweight of the band. They're just too small or too big, and they're far too. First time in the history of boxing, pound for pound, one and two have faced.
Yeah.
And look at what pound for pound one done to pound for pound two.
Yeah.
He made them look like a novice. That is not because Pacquiao is so bad, it's just that Floyd Mayweather is so good, and people need to appreciate him while he's here, and really get behind him, because, at the end of the day, I'll be told, I don't think we're going to see another one like him.
No.
For our generation, anyway, from our era.
Speaking of Floyd Mayweather, obviously he calls himself the best ever. Mm. Would you say, in your personal opinion, he's the best ever?
That's very tough. I'm an historian in boxing, and I know Sugar Ray Robinson.
Yeah.
I was watching the Sugar Ray Leonard and a prime Roy Jones Jr. What I will say is his name should be spoken. When you speak boxing, you come up with names. First thing you say, boxing, you say, well, who do you think of? And you say, Sugar Ray Leonard, Sugar Ray Robinson, Muhammad Ali, Floyd Mayweather.
Yeah,
that's out.
Yeah,
I'm not saying that in any order, But when you mention names in boxing, his name has to be mentioned from now on. You know, you say boxing, you say Floyd Mayweather. So
that's it, definitely. Well, that's all from us today. Tony, thanks a lot for giving us your time.
Pleasure,
and best of luck for June 26th.
Pleasure, mate. Thank you.